Horizons, it is divided into three groups: central, spinal, and the peripheral. Among the central, we have to once again subclassify into stimulant, depressant, and deliriant. Among the deliriant, we are going to see all the deliriant type of poison. First, we have a Datura poisoning. Before that, what is delirium? Delirium is a state, is an acute, reversible, agitated state of confusion. In this state, the individual could not justify himself. He could not able to take rest or fallen asleep. There will be no drowsiness at all, but there will be convulsions, hallucinations, and delusions. In the delusion, he could not recognize his family members or friends itself. It's an acute, agitated state of confusion. It's a reversible one. So the first among the delirant poisons are Datura. We have seen all over the Tamil Nadu in the childhood, we used to make our classroom slate more darker to write this plant, Umatangai, Umatanchedi. So in India, we have two types of Datura plants. According to the color of the flower, if the flower is white in color, it is Datura alba. If the flower is deep purple in color, it is Datura niger. The flower is in both types of plant, it is long, bell shaped. Regarding fruit of Datura, it is a sharp, long spikes or spines present on the surface of the fruit. It is green in color when it is unripe. There are many thorns presenting on the surface of the fruit. It is called a thorn apple, T-H-O-R-N, thorn apple. It's a peculiarity of this Datura plant. When broken, it has many number of Datura seeds, up to more than 500 in number. They are dark yellowish brown in color. These are poisonous. What are the active principles present in the Datura plant? Hyoscine or scopolamine and hyoscyamine. Some traces of atropine also present. These are all the three active principles present in the Datura plant: hyoscine or scopolamine, hyoscyamine, and traces of atropine. These hyoscine, atropine, hyoscyamine are alkaloid in nature. Before going into deep, we have to know a little bit about what is alkaloid. Alkaloid, the term itself define what is it? Alkali like action, alkaloid. So what generally alkali do? It usually react with acid to form salts. It is a complex structures with the nitrogen base. So this is the most common chemical nature of any active principles. After alkaloid, we have some glucosides or glycosides. Most commonly, active principles are in nature of alkaloid. We have both natural alkaloid and synthetic alkaloids. Examples for natural alkaloids, strychnine, this hyoscine, hyoscyamine, atropine, etc. These are all natural alkaloid. In the laboratory, we can produce alkaloid synthetically. examples for synthetic alkaloid is amphetamine, etc. So some alkaloids are resistant for putrefaction. Even after death, after decomposition of the body, the alkaloid can be detected, can be retrieved from the dead body during chemical analysis. Examples for resistant alkaloids are this strychnine poisoning and datura plants. Examples for rapidly decomposing, rapidly destroying alkaloids is cocaine. Cocaine decomposes very fastly in the dead body. So datura is hyoscine and hyoscyamine are alkaloid in nature. Generally, these alkaloids are acting in the central nervous system. First, it stimulates the higher centers in the brain. Then, after prolonging time, it depresses the medulla, the vital centers. So, what are all the clinical features of datura? It is a dysphagia it produces and the dryness of mouth. The face will be flush. The pupil will be dilated and the diplopia, temporary blindness may occur. After that, urinary retention, the individual could not pass urine as much as possible. Then the skin will be dry and hot skin. Increased body temperature leads to hyperpyrexia, increased muscle tone, delirium, convulsions, coma. Because of involvement of medullary centers, vital centers in the medulla, death will occur due to respiratory paralysis. Many times the datura seeds may have taken in the thought of capsicum seeds. So we have to know how to differentiate datura seeds and capsicum seeds. Datura seeds is a kidney shape, but a capsicum seed is a round shape. Datura is larger and thicker when compared to capsicum seed. Capsicum seed is light yellow in color, but datura seed is dark brown in color. For taste wise, datura seed is bitter, capsicum is pungent. Similarly, no smell in the datura seed, but pungent odor may be present in the capsicum seed. There is a concave in the middle of the datura seed, but it is entirely circular in case of the capsicum seed. On cut section, there will be an embryo present inside the seed. The embryo is inward turned in case of capsicum seed, but outward turned in case of datura seed. So this is the differences between datura seeds and the capsicum seed. Why I am putting this slide is frequently asking short notes, differentiate between datura seeds and the capsicum seed. What are the clinical features of the datura poisoning? You have to, if you remember these 8 D's, you can write very easily. Dysphagia, dry mouth, drowsiness, dry and hot skin, dilated pupil. We are studying about delirium poison. So in case of datura, you can write delirium, then drunken gait across death. Up to 100 to 125 seeds are need to kill the individual, or 1 gram of hyoscine. Death will occur within 24 hours of consumption. What is the treatment of datura poisoning? Emetics to coming out from the GI tract orally. Gastric lavage can be done with the help of tannic acid or weak solution of potassium permanganate. Activated charcoal also we can give. The entire bowel should be irrigated to remove the unabsorbed datura seeds, datura poisons. Physostigmine injection 1 milligram, either intramuscularly or intravenously, should be given. as a specific antidote. Injection pilocarpine 5 mg subcutaneously can be given. Don't give morphine, since morphine aggravate the vital centers depression, so death will occur in case of morphine is used. And because of delirium nature, the delirium should be treated with short acting barbiturates or ether or chloroform. The individual should be given very light diet, and purgatives should be continued for up to 3 to 4 days to wash the entire GI tract. What are the postmortem appearances? Postmortem appearances, no specific appearance except lung edema, and there will be signs of asphyxia like cyanosis, congestion of internal organs, fluidity of blood, and dark red vesical hemorrhages on the surface of lungs, under surface of scalp, and surface of heart also. What are the medico-legal importance? Don't forget to remember as a roadside poison, since frequently asking short notes, and definitely you'd be asked in 5 hours. What is the most commonly used roadside poison? Sir, Datura. The decoction of Datura plant or powders of seeds can be mixed with the curry or tea or juices or snacks or liquor can may be given to the passengers on the railway track or bus travelers. After consuming the Datura mixed eateries, the individual go fall asleep and they could not remember what is happening around them. They will be present in the drowsy state. After the drowsiness of the victims, the accused or assailant may theft the properties or used for robberies. Sometimes for rape also, the Datura plant juice, decoction or seed powder may be given to the victim and the sexual assault. So most common roadside poisoning is Datura. Abortifacient also used. The Datura decoction can be used for aphrodisiac. Children may succumb because of accidental poisoning in the thought of fruits. Suicidal also common. Homicidal, it is rare. If Datura is mixed with tobacco, can be used as smoke to increase the toxicity. It can be mixed with the alcohol, pink toxicity, used as low filter. Under the influence of Datura poisonous, the individual is criminally not responsible for his actions, since because he is not able to judge the nature and the consequences of action, so he is not criminally not responsible. It is a type of alkaloid which resists putrefaction. The Datura seeds or hyoscine or scopolamine can be extracted from the cadaver after death, even after 4 years of the death. That much it resists putrefaction. How to confirm the given solution contain hyoscine or scopolamine and Datura decoction? It is called as mydriatic test. The solution is poured on the conjunctiva. You have to wait for half an hour. If it contains atropine or hyoscine, there will be a dilatation of pupil. If the pupil gets dilated, it is confirmed that the given solution contains atropine or scopolamine. The next delirium is Cannabis indica or Cannabis sativa. It is present all over the world. In India also, it is growing all over the world, but under restriction by law. Both male and female plants are there. female plants are taller and darker than male plants. It having active principles like cannabinol and cannabidiol. Both cannabinol and cannabidiol are inert, non-toxic. These cannabinol and cannabidiol, when exposed to heat, it produce isomeric tetrahydrocannabinol. These isomeric tetrahydrocannabinol is highly toxic in nature. We have many types of cannabis in the commercial side. Number one is called bhang. Bhang is a substance produced from the dried leaves of cannabis indica or cannabis sativa plant. It is highly toxic and narcotics. It contains 15% of active principles of cannabinol. Second one is majun. Majun is a sweet preserved prepared with the help of bhang. It is used as aphrodisiac and increased duration of sexual activity. And majun is a sweet. Then ganja. Ganja is a part of a female plant. Is a dried flower of female plant. It is a topmost part of the plant. It is dark green in color. It contains 15 to 20% of alkaloid cannabinoids. Fourth one is charas. This is a resin produced from the stem of the cannabis sativa plant. It contains 40% of alkaloids. What are the clinical features of cannabis indica? If it is ingested through smoking, the clinical features occurs within few minutes. If it is swallowed, the clinical feature appears within half an hour. If it is mild exposure, euphoria, passivity, heightening of experience, and disorientation. If it is moderate, impaired memory, disturbed thought pattern, unfamiliarity. If it is severe, depersonalization and sensory distortion. What is the toxicity of cannabis indica? We have two types of toxicity: psychiatric features and the physical features. In physical features, we have increased appetite, increased thirst, nausea, vomiting, tachycardia, increased urinary frequency, ataxia, tremors. In case of psychiatric features, the individual feel detachment from the surroundings, depersonalization, euphoria, increased self-esteem or self-confidence levels, irrelevant thought process, changes in speech and impaired judgments, altered sexual feelings, and trip. What is trip? Trip is a psychiatric features of cannabis indica. In the state, the individual will feel like flying from the high open window, and the individual thought that he can able to stop the running bus with bare hands. It is called as trip. How to treat cannabis indica poisoning? Stomach wash with lukewarm water or weak potassium permanganate solution or tannic acid. You have to give coma cocktail preparation. What is coma cocktail preparation? It is a combination of naloxone, thiamine, and 50% of glucose. Convulsions may be treated with injection diazepam intravenously or intramuscularly. The flashback phenomena can be treated with haloperidol drug. Psychotherapy is more important to treat the psychiatric features of the cannabisin indica poisoning. In chronic poisoning, the individual is in the state of run amok. What is run amok? Run amok is definitely asking short notes or oral questions. What is run amok? In case of cannabis poisoning, the individual feel personality disorder, paranoid features, and he is run here and there, and is having intention to kill whoever come in his way or her way, with thought of real or imaginary enmity. After killing the neighbors around him, he may commit suicide or he may surrender himself to the police person. It's called run amok. Is a features of chronic cannabis indica poisoning. Accidental poison because of overindulgence. After Datura, these cannabis also used as a roadside poison. Sometimes by accused or assailants, the cannabis indica may be taken before criminal acts to increase their nerve strength. It also used as aphrodisiac, and it's supposed to be used to increase the duration of sexual activity. Then cocaine. Cocaine is a plant poison produced in the Erythroxylum coca. It's a colorless, odorless, white, crystalline powder. If the cocaine is mixed with baking soda or water, it is called as crack. It is used for smoke to increase the toxicity features. What is the mechanism of action? It desensitizes the terminal nerves, leads to vasoconstriction of all over the body. Like other deliriant, this also first stimulant to the central nervous system, then depress the vital centers in the medulla. This has a sympathomimetic action. In cocaine poisoning, we have two stage of features. First one is stage of excitement because of stimulant nature. Here the individual having increased breathing, tachycardia, euphoria, convulsions, excitement. Then after that, there will be a stage of depression. In the depression, bradycardia, apnea, convulsions, coma, death. There are chances of increased systemic hypertension, accelerated or malignant hypertension leads to intracerebral bleed, leads to cerebrovascular disease. If the cocaine is mixed with heroin, in the injected form, it is called as speedball. Fatal period within few minutes to few hours. Treatment for cannabis indica poison, airway, breathing, circulation. If it is ingested, stomach wash can be given with weak tannic acid or potassium permanganate solution. If it is snuffed, it can be washed with just simple lukewarm water. If it is injected poison, there will be application of tourniquet or ligature above the level of injection. Convulsions can be treated with short-acting barbiturate, chloroform, or ether. Similarly, like cocaine poison, you have to use amyl nitrate. Then coma cocktail preparation also useful. Chronic abusers are called as cocainophagia or cocainism. Here, one point is important. Cocaine bugs are magnum symptoms. What is cocaine bug? the individual after using chronic cocaine, they feel a crawling of insects or feeling of sand on the back of the body or front of the body. He feels that there are some insects crawling on the surface of the skin, so it leads to continuous scratch and non-healing ulcers on the surface. It's a tactile hallucination called cocaine bugs or magnet symptoms. What are the PM changes in cocaine poison? Because of continuous arrhythmia, there are focus of scarring on the surface of heart. During the postmortem, the blood should be preserved with the addition of fluorides. The cocaine is a type of alkaloid which decomposes very rapidly. And in case of snuffing, the cocaine can be retrieved from the oral or nasal mucosa. If it is injected, we can recover the cocaine from the site of injection. What is medico-legal importance? Prostitutes can inject the cocaine into their lower genital tract to produce vasoconstriction. It uses aphrodisiac. Generally, cocaine addicts are there. The addictions may succumb because of accidental poisoning. Suicidal and homicidal poisoning are rare in case of cocaine. Then we are moving towards spinal poisons. Spinal poisons, we have two poisons, Strychnus nuxvomica and gelsemium. We'll see poisonous effects of Strychnus nuxvomica in detail. It's a plant poison. Here the fruit is a rough, glossy orange, spherical, smooth surface fruit. When cut section, it has a white, jelly or pale yellow colored pulp will be present. Within the fruit, there are 3 to 5 nuxvomica seeds are there. These nuxvomica seed are 3 to 5 centimeter in diameter, both concave and convex surface. There will be on surface radiating silky fibers are there. These are hard and difficult to pulverize. These seeds contains 3 types of active principles: strychnine, brucine, and loganin. These strychnine and brucine are alkaloid in nature, loganin are glucose in nature. This is a pronounced words strychnine, not strychnine, it's a strychnine. Strychnine is a colorless, odorless, rhombic crystals poison. Regarding toxicokinetics, it acts on the anterior horn cells or ventral horn cells of ascending nervous system. Generally, it inhibits the glycine. Generally, glycine is termed as a universal inhibitor in the spinal cord. It inhibits the inhibitors, so the result action is release excitation. Because of the action is excitation, there will be convulsions and spasm of entire skeletal muscles of the body all over. So the clinical features is pertaining to muscles of all over the body. There will be initial convulsions, initially chronic in nature, later on tonic convulsions. The specific features is risus sardonicus. What is risus sardonicus? Is a contraction of muscles of lower part of face. in which the muscles of lips and mouth were dragged towards the ears. It is called as a smile of Joker. There will be collection of frothy blood-stained fluid around the mouth. If the contraction and convulsions are involved on back of the muscles, the position is opisthotonus. If the involvement is outer side of the body, it is pleurostotonus. If the muscles involved on front of the body or ventral surface, the position is emprostotonus. What will happen after consuming? The clinical features appears within 1 hour. All the poisons are acted in the motor neuron junction. The muscles started to twitch. There will be spasm and contractions of the muscles. After the clonic and the tonic convulsions, there is a gap. During the gap, there will be all the muscles are in relaxed phase. It is a contradicting facts of tetanus. After relaxing, sometimes if the individual feel any disturbance or any noise or any air entry, once again the clonic and the tonic convulsions will start. So the second clonic and tonic convulsions are severe in nature. Later on, respiratory paralysis will occur, the individual will die after inhibition of respiratory center in the medulla. This phase will occur within 2 or 3 hours after consumption of poison. Battle period is 1 to 2 hours. Single seed is enough to kill the individual, provided that if the seed should be consumed after crushing. If the seed is uncrushed, it coming out through the GI tract without any action. Uncrushed seed was inert one. The individual will escape. The individual should consume crushed seed. Then only the strychnine poison will exert toxic effects. How to differentiate strychnine poisoning and tetanus? For strychnine poisoning, the history of injury, and strychnine poisoning, the convulsions is sudden, but in tetanus it will be gradual in nature. Convulsions for strychnine poisoning, all the muscles are involved at the same time, but in tetanus not all the muscles at the same time. In the interconvulsion period, the muscles will be relaxed in case of strychnine poisoning. But if the tetanus, all the muscles are rigid one. In case of a chemical examination in the blood, we can retrieve the strychnine. But in case of tetanus, there will be no poisonous agent at all. The individual will die within 2 hours after the first clonic and tonic convulsion in case of strychnine poisoning. It takes at least more than 24 hours in case of tetanus to die. How to treat? First, we have to control the convulsions. For control the convulsion, the individual should kept in the dark room without passing light into the room, without passing any sound or any stimulant into the room. If any stimulant happened, the individual started to throw fits. Injection diazepam intravenously and intramuscularly should be given to treat convulsions. Phenobarbiturates like phenobarbital. If the measures failed, general anesthetic agent should be given to control the convulsion with the muscle relaxant. Ether may be also used to treat the convulsions. The specific antidote for strychnine poisoning is pentobarbital sodium or sodium amytal. Stomach wash can be given with activated charcoal, tannic acid and the potassium permanganate. If the urine acidify, there is fast elimination excretion of strychnine metabolites through urine. In that case, the urine pH should be make within the range of 4.5 to 7. What is the postmortem appearance? Except early appearance of rigor mortis. The rigor mortis should appear early. Why? Because the muscle are already in spasm. So the appearance of rigor mortis will be very early. But there is no change of time in disappearance of rigor mortis in case of strychnine poisoning. After that, signs of asphyxia will be there. How to confirm the given solution has contained strychnine? It is called as physiological test. The given solution should be injected into the dorsal lymph of the frog. After injecting the given solution into the dorsal lymph, the frog should start to throw fits, seizures, convulsions. After a few minutes, there will be no convulsions at all. Then after 10 to 15 minutes, if you disturb the frog, once again, convulsion will start. It indicates the given solution has contained strychnine. It's called physiological test. Accidental poisoning are more common by seeing the by taking fruits and seeds. It was used as a homicidal also. Arrow poisons, aphrodisiac poison, cattle poison. Suicide is very rare. Why? Because the death is painful. For ideal suicidal poisoning, we have seen many characteristics. It's cheap, easily available, tasteless. The pain, the death should be painless. Here, the death is severe painful, so nobody take a chance to consume strychnine for suicide. Then peripheral nerve poisons, we have two types of poisons. Curare, it acts on the peripheral nerve and motor neuron junction. It blocks the postsynaptic acetylcholine receptors. Treatment, muscle relaxant like isostigmine, galamine, succinylcholine, etc. Please remember, it is not poison when ingestion. It is given in the injection form. Clinical features, muscular spasms, dysphagia, bitter taste in the tongue. Treatment, same treatment. Postmortem appearance, signs of asphyxia will be present. The last one is corneum maculatum. Service called as hemlock. It's a poison given to Socrates for judicial execution in 399 BC. The active principle is conine. It gives ascending paralysis from lower extremity up to the head and neck muscles. Fatal dose 60 milligram of conine active principle is enough to kill the individual. Clinical features, convulsions, muscular spasm, tightness in the chest, respiratory paralysis. So here, Datura poisons may be asked as a essay, run amok, Magnon symptoms, or cocaine bug will ask in the short notes are 5 hours. Strychnus nuxvomica is one of the major essay question. And 8 D's are more important in short notes in case of Datura poisoning. In 5 hours, roadside poisons will be asked. Roadside poisons are examples. Datura and cocaine. Thank you for listening, class.